Hello friends, in last video we have seen types of canal and its design. I will just repeat design procedure here, then we will take two problems. In design, there are two types of design in case of Kennedy's theory, or we can say there are two methods or two types. In first one, QNMS is given. That is discharge, rugosity coefficient, CVR ratio and longitudinal slope is given. How the canal is designed? Design means simply we have to find out bottom width, depth of flow, side slope. This is the design. So in first case, QNMS is given. We'll assume depth and then we'll carry out discharge. We'll carry out design. We'll take one numerical on this and our idea will be clear. Design an irrigation channel to carry a discharge of 4.5 cubic meter per second. Rugosity coefficient value N, capital N is equal to 0.0225. CVR ratio M is 1 and longitudinal slope S equal to 0.16 meter per kilometer length of canal. We have to design this for this given data. Here you see Q is given, N is given, M is given and S is given. So for designing such type of problem, there are various iterations. Now here, first we'll assume depth D. We'll assume depth D. We will find out V0, that is critical velocity ratio by Kennedy's theory, 0.55 md raised to power 0.64. By substituting value of m and assuming d equal to 2 meter, we will get this 0.857. Then we can find out area. Q by V, Q is known, V is calculated. Then this is another formula which I already derived. A is equal to BD plus D square by 2, where side slope is half is to 1. From this A is just we have calculated, D is assumed, we can find out bed width B. Once you know bed width B, we can find out weighted perimeter P is B plus D root 5. Then R, that is hydraulic mean depth, is A by P. A we have calculated, P we have calculated, will get value of R. Now we are finding out this R, that is hydraulic mean depth, to find out the mean velocity by Cutter's formula. We have calculated critical velocity V0 as 0.857, but we have to check this by Cutter's formula and substituting all the values of N, S and hydraulic mean depth R in Cutter's formula, we will get mean velocity as 0.18.6 and we will compare these two velocities. This is our critical velocity by Kennedy's formula. This will be the actual velocity in a canal by Cutter's formula. If we compare these two values, we can see that this is higher one. We have to reduce this velocity. To reduce this, how we can reduce this velocity? Because this is assumed. Based on this assumed value of D, we got this velocity V. We have to reduce this velocity because actual velocity is going to happen 0.18.1816. So we have to reduce this velocity. How we can reduce this velocity? If we lower the depth of water, automatically bed width will increase and velocity will reduce. We have to take second trial. So for second trial, we will just jump by 1 meter. Even we can take 1.5 meter. Then we'll compare these two values and we can reach to. So we will take 1 meter. Again, we'll carry same one. We'll find out V0, area, bed width, perimeter, hydraulic mean depth, and this is by Cutter. Now you see, this is 0.55, 0.475. This is nearly equal or reducing, matching, as compared 0.85, 0.18. This is nearly equal. Again, we see here, this is higher than this value. Again, value is to be reduced. Depth assumed is to be reduced. We will take 0.8. Here, we can take 0.5 also. But since it is iteration, 0.8, again, we will compare this value. Now, you can compare 0.47, 0.44. This is reaching nearly to each other. Again, 0.6, 0.39, 0.37. Now, I think if you consider 0.4 or 0.5, this will match. Suppose we are stopping our iteration here. What we can say? We'll say for a discharge 4.5 Qmax and value of n is 0.0225. Longitudinal slope S is 0.16 per kilometer and had CVR ratio m equal to 1, our section of a channel will be such that its depth of flow is 0.6, bottom width of a canal is 18.61 meter. This will be my section. If I provide this section 0.6 meter depth and this is bottom width, longitudinal slope is 0.16 per kilometer in that particular area, having rugosity coefficient n equal to 0.0225, my velocity will be 0.393966. That is critical velocity, which will match with by Cutter's formula, and this critical velocity is non-silting, non-scoring velocity. If I provide a flow through this channel with this velocity, this is non-silting, means this velocity will not allow to settle down the silt, which is non-silting. At the same time, this velocity is non-scoring. That means this velocity is non-scoring. This velocity during its flow, it will not score either the bed or the sides. This is design. This is a first part. Or we can say, when Q and M is given, how it is designed by the Kennedy's theory. Now we'll take second numerical by Kennedy's theory, in which iteration is not required. Iterations is not required, but B by D ratio is given. There are two types of problem. In first, you will have to carry iteration, B by D is not given. In second problem, B by D ratio means bottom width to the depth ratio is given by Kennedy based on his experience during working in irrigation department in Punjab. Now in this case, Q, N, M and instead of S, B by D is given. Q and M and B by D is given. Now how this problem should be solved? B by D is 5.7, this is given. Therefore, B is equal to 5.7D. This is equation number 1. Okay? B is equal to 5.7D, this is equation number 1. Area, this is our standard formula which you already derived. Area equal to BD plus D square by 2. Again, I am clearing here that this is D square by 2, or we can say half into D square, where half is side slope, that is Z. Otherwise, this formula is BD plus ZD square. Okay. Now, we will substitute value of B here. We will get this area equal to, in term of D square, velocity V is 0.55 MD raised to power 0.64. This is by Cutter's formula. This is by Kennedy's equation of critical velocity. This is equation number 2. This is equation number 3. And discharge by continuity equation Q equal to A into V. Q is known, that is 1.4. Area is in term of D. Velocity is in term of D. Now, from this equation, we can find out value of D, that is depth. And if you substitute this in equation number 1, we will get B. Now, we have decided value of D and value of B. Okay, that means section is designed. Designing this channel section, that means bottom width B and D, we have to find out. At the same time, another parameter S, that is longitudinal slope is to be found out, and that longitudinal slope we can calculate here as like this, either by Cutter's formula or Manning's formula. In the previous case, we had to compare that velocity with the Cutter's formula. S was given. In this case, S is not given. We have to find out S. S means longitudinal slope, and that can be found out by Manning's formula or by using Cutter's formula. Again, in Cutter's formula, what are the requirement? Cutter's formula, velocity is equal to something, that is N and R and S are there in formula. That is N, hydraulic mean, N is rugosity coefficient, S is longitudinal slope, R is hydraulic mean depth. In previous case, velocity was compared. In this case, velocity is known. So here, by using either by Manning's formula or by Cutter's formula, we can find out value of S. Velocity V is 1 by L, R is to 2/3 S to stop. This is the Manning's formula. V is known, just we have calculated, 0.77. N is rugosity coefficient, R is hydraulic mean depth, that is A by P. A is a weighted area, P is a weighted perimeter, that we can find out from this one. S raised to half, from this S is calculated 1:4888, or by Cutter's formula we can find out. These are the only two designs in case of Kennedy's theory. Okay.